Hello friends, you are watching ERUDIRE PLUS, the professional CAD CAM solution provider. Let's get started.
Hello viewers, today I'll show modeling of a single pass heat exchanger. It can be utilized both as a counterflow or parallel flow heat exchanger, and the modeling will be done using SolidWorks software. So without wasting time, let us start our modeling. While modeling this one, it is better to select the right plane, normal to, and start sketching from circles. Let us draw two concentric circles with any dimensions. And let us point smart dimension to this one as 60mm and 50mm. 60 will be the external diameter and 50 will be internal diameter. And the inner one will be 50mm. Done. Accept this drawing with gain check. Then we have to extrude this one with a depth of 1400mm. Features, extrude board space, and that to be extruded from the middle plane. From middle plane, we'll extrude this one with a depth of 1400mm. Done. Now we can accept this one with gain check. Again, in the right plane, we have to draw another concentric circles with different diameters. Right plane, normal to. We select two concentric circles with diameter 100mm and 90mm. Sketch circles. Let us apply smart dimension to this one as 100mm and 90mm. Second one will be 90mm. Done. Accept this one at pin check. Then we have to extrude this one again with a depth of 1200mm. So features, extrude boss base, and we want to extrude from the middle plane with a depth of 1200mm. Accept this one with gain check. Done. Next one, on this surface again we have to close some concentric circles. To make this one completely closed, select that span, sketch. Now can draw one circle at the surface with a diameter of 90mm. One circle is drawn, another circle you have to draw. Done. Accept this one and again check. And that to be extruded with a depth of 10mm inside. Right? Same thing to be done in the other side also. We have to draw two concentric circles and that to be extruded with a depth of 10mm inside. Accept this one green check, and extrusion depth should be 10mm inside. Let us extrude this one. It is extruded. For viewing the geometry, we can have a segmented view of this model. Let us cut it from front plane and check. It's fine. At a specific distance away from the top plane, we have to make some other planes. Planes. Let us change the distance. Let us make the distance to be 100mm. Accept this one with gain check. We'll select the top plane, normal to, and on that plane, we have to start some sketching. We'll start some circle at the top plane. We'll draw two concentric circles of diameter 50 and 60mm, and we can put smart dimension to this one as distance from the edge, it will be 75mm, and the outer diameter will be 60mm, and the inner diameter will be 50mm. Accept this one with gain check. Now that to be extruded up to that surface, features, extrude boss base, and we can extrude this one up to a specific surface, up to this surface. Now that to be extruded up to a specific surface, instead of blind, we will make this one up to surface. Let us select a surface, done, green check, accepted. Another thing is the top part, if we see some cut portion should be there, we can view this. You can see the segmented view of this model. There should be some kind of cut, right? We should have some cut portion in this location. So for doing this one, we select that plane again, sketch. Now we'll select the previous sketch again, convert entities. Same circles are drawn. We don't want the outer circle. Done. Accept this drawing and that to be cut up to this surface. Features extrude cut. That to be cut with a specific surface. Up to surface. We select the inner side of this one. Select it up to the surface. Done. So we can see that right now, this is a cut view. This one will be the cold fluid region and this one will be hot fluid region. Exactly the same way, in the down plane also you have to do the same thing. So we'll select the top plane, and with respect to this top plane, we have to make another plane in the downside at a distance of 100 millimeter. So we can flip that direction. Plane is made. Now on plane 2, we have to make the same drawing again. Plane 2 selected. Sketch. We have to start one drawing at this location. Let us provide smart dimension to this one as 50 and 60 millimeter. And the inner one will be 50 millimeter. And its distance from the side, it will be 75 millimeter. Done. Accept this drawing with green check. Now that to be extruded up to the surface. Features, extrude boss base, and instead of blind, we have to make this one up to surface. Let us select that surface. Accept this one with green check. Done. We can see this one by rotating. This is done. Again, some cut is required at this location, right? So what we'll do is, we'll follow the same trend what we did before. Select the plane, sketch. Then we can go back to our previous model and we have to use the same sketch. Convert entities. Two circles are drawn. Outer circle, we don't want that to be trimmed out. Accept this drawing with green check, and then that to be extrude cut up to specific surface. Features, extrude cut up to specific surface. You can rotate this one up to this one. We want to extrude cut up to this surface. Selected, green check. Discard, right? So we can view this model in a better way. That is, this is the passage of hot fluid and this is the passage of cold fluid. So this part is considering as a jacket. Let us have a complete view of this model. We can hide this lens, and to make the model complete, we can put some kind of leads at the entry and exit locations. That can be provided from here. Show solution, tools, create leads. Directly you can create leads at these locations. First lead is made. This is the second lead. Again, other side also you can provide some other leads. Third lead is made. This is the fourth lead. Now the drawing is complete. Accept this one with green check. All the leads are provided. Now for metal look, we can change the appearance with metallic appearance. That can be provided from here. Appearance. We can provide copper for this single pass heat exchanger. This is made up of copper. And to have a better look, we can change the background also. Let us make it plain white. So this is our model. And to view this one perfectly, you can have a segmented view of this model from front plane. Right, so you can see this is the passage of hot fluid and this is the passage of cold fluid. So if you are using this one as a counterflow heat exchanger, this will be the inlet of cold fluid and this will be the exit of cold fluid, right? And this one will be the inlet of hot fluid and this one will be the exit of hot fluid. Okay, this is a very simple model. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to learn SolidWorks and CFD, you can see my Udemy courses. The link of that one is provided in the description box. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.
If you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.